Marvin Gaye shot dead by his father. Motorola introduced the world's first mobile phone. Serial killer Dennis Nielsen gets life. Brinksmat robbery nets $37.5 million. MASH is only just 15 and has been relieved of his schooling duties with no chance of taking any exams.
Hey! Now, later, ramblers! Welcome to 1983. Hey! I'm 15 and I like glue and gas. Yeah. Yeah. It's my life. I do what I want because I come from a broken home. Yeah, and I've learned everything I need to from school, so I'm not bothering doing my last year. Although, that wasn't strictly my decision. Yeah. But I'll take it. Anyway, so it's 1983. And in sport, Liverpool won the first division. FA Cup was won by the other team that are not called Manchester City, that play in red, after a replay with Brighton. Steve Cram, in his little shorts. Steve Cram won the BBC Sports Personality of the Year by getting to the finish line quicker than all the other blokes. Yeah. Alrighty, let's get on to them TV themes. Three classics. First one, dead simple. Second one, if you know, you know. Third one, oh, she's a toughie. So I'll play you three TV themes, have a guess what they are, and I'll tell you at the end. Here's your first one. And your second one. And your third one, more difficult. Brilliant. Tell you what they are later. Other shows on telly in 1983. The A-Team. Ain't got no playing bars. Whoo! The A-Team. Yeah, I used to like Howling Mad Murdoch. Halfway to Zen Pet. Brilliant series. Blackadder. Very, very good. Banana Man. Shite. Tucker's Luck. Shite. The Moomins, Moomin Troll, Moomin Mummer, shite! Blockbusters, I'll have a pee please, Bob.
Oh, I never used to not make me laugh when people said that.
And the thing with Blockbusters was, I remember, something really fucking simple. I was shouting at the telly, but because they were quite bright kids, they didn't have much common sense, did they? And as my lad pointed out when he was about 9 years old, he said, Dad, I said, stop calling me that. He says, Dad, he says, common sense. He says, it's not that common, is it? Fucking profound for somebody from nine. You came from my loins, boy. He-Man, shite. The first breakfast TV show was aired in 1983. Never saw it. I think it was a morning thing, and I've never seen it since. Brilliant films from 83. Octopussy. You wouldn't even be able to fucking call it that now, would you? Scarface. Trading Places. Fantastic. And Flashdance, complete with leotard and camel toe. Yeah, be a moose's knuckle now, won't it? Music, what was happening? I'll tell you what was happening. It was the first ever, now that's what I call music, album, which I do have on vinyl. That's vinyl. Yeah, now that's what I call ripping off as many artists as possible with one album. The biggest selling single in the UK in 1983 was Camera Chameleon. Ah. Yes, dads all around the country staring at top of the pops. Very confused, they were having odd feelings within themselves. Is that a boy or a girl? I don't know, but I like it nevertheless. Boy George, yeah, he did question a lot of people, didn't he? Metallica were formed in 1983. Fair play. Respect to Metallica. Jacko, Wacko Jacko, did his famous I've got dog shit on me shoe dance and called it a moonwalk. What I like to think he had indeed stood in shit. It's the first time he'd ever done it. This was quite a sad moment. On Christmas Day, Marvin Gaye bought his dad an unlicensed Smith & Wesson 38 special caliber pistol. Yeah, who'd have thought? Turned out shortly after, his dad popped a cap in his ass and fucking killed him, didn't he? So, bit of a shit Christmas present, to be honest. If you were, I don't think he thought it through, did he? The Flying Pickets were number one at Christmas. Luxembourg won Eurovision. I've been to Luxembourg, weird country. Very cheap petrol and tabs. So if you think of filling your car up and you fancy 20 tabs, get yourself to Luxembourg. Right, I've recorded a song. Check out, as usual, all these pictures that will get the old cogs going. You do like a bit of it. You've got everything happening from 1983 around the world. And enjoy this song from a singer who sadly is no longer with us. The band are still on the go. But if you ever got a chance to see them in the 80s, they were fantastic. Big Country. Fields of Fire. Bang my head on the telly.
Between a father and a son, between the city and the world, before the teacher and the test, before the journey and the rest, shining night will never cry, the beating heart will never die, the house of fire holds no shame. Thank you.
Oh, Bob Fleming here. 3, 2, 1. Back in the room. Did you enjoy that? Yeah, can't whack a bit of big country. So, back to 1983. Scottish serial killer Dennis Nielsen was convicted on at least 12 counts of murder, possibly 15. The space shuttle Challenger, wow, was launched. And the first ever £1 coin was brought out. The Walton sextuplets. All six babies were female and born in Liverpool. Of course they fucking were. Where else were they going to be born? Loads on them. The Brinksmat robbery warehouse at Heathrow. Wow, what a tickle. They stole 3 tons of gold bars worth $37.5 million. Wow, what a steal. Mash, what, mate? What were the most popular boys and girls' names in the UK? Oh, glad you asked. Christopher and Sarah. Yeah, there was only two. Right, let's get on to cars. Ford Fiestas, 83. Fiat Uno. The Land Rover Defender. But the biggest news that shocked a lot of people and still can't get my head round, in January was made law to have to wear a seatbelt if you were shotgun in the front. Yeah. Which is still law to this day. Unless, of course, you're married to a billionaireess who doesn't pay any tax in the UK and you are her unelected Tory Prime Minister gimp puppet of an husband. Get him out! Bike wankers! Hing, 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 hing! Oh! Oh, you wait for this! The Yamaha XJ900. What a machine! Air-cooled, double overhead camshaft. Oh! Stop there, Matt. Oh, no, no. It also had an 8-valve engine, triple disc brakes, and... Oh! Oh! A handlebar mounted bikini fairing. Oh, God! Fucking grow up! It's a bike! And slow down while you're there. Right, prices in the UK. In 83, gallon of petrol, £1.76. A pint of Hofmeister, follow the bear, 67 pence, happy days. And for the ladies, 4 cans of Kestrel would set you back £1.35. 20 John Player king size, I remember them well. £1. Ooh, bit of an oik. A prescription was only £1.40. But there was less shit wrong with people then because they weren't getting stuff dropped out of the sky by chemtrails, were they? Or were they? Panasonic VHS recorder. Wow, this is staggering. £399.95. Fuck. Now, your average weekly wage isn't going to be a feature anymore. Okay? Because the no-tails, the women, they've gone too far. They're over £100 a bloody week now. And it's just wrong. And I, for one, am not fueling the fire that they're already pyre of burning bras is spitting out. So that's that. No more wages. Let's have some firsts. This was an odd one. The first ever Motorola mobile phone was introduced. I wonder if that's going to catch on. Dunno. First time anybody found wheel clamps. Yeah, bastard. The first Dyson bagless Hoover. Wow. The first Swatch watch. Now, I've never
I've never owned a watch. I've never owned one. I don't want one. Never owned one. I don't get the concept why you need a constant reminder that you're a second closer to your fucking inevitable death. Why would you? This was a classic. The first camcorder. A perverse game changer. Oh, yes. A little bit wider, wider. Yep, yep, perfect, love. Oh, we've all done it, haven't we? No? Just me again. Oh, well. Food and drink. Chicken McNuggets. Because they can't be nuggets, they have to be called McNuggets. And then this was brought out. Remember the advert? I've got the tune from it. Have a listen.
Way down deep in the middle of the Congo, a hippo took an apricot, a guava, and a mango. He stuck it with the others and he danced a dilly tango. The rhino said, I know, we'll call it Umbongo. Umbongo, the trigger in the Congo. Python picked the passion fruit, the mama said, the mandarin, the parrot painted pandas, got the hunk of Google landed it. So when it comes to sun and fun and goodness in the...
Yeah, that was it. Umbongo. Basically, fruity, e-numbered shite. Yeah. Fashion. Turn to the left. What was happening in fashion? Well, I'm going to tell you. Because it was bizarre. Strong shoulder pads. Oversized coats. Accessorized with, get this, the power belt that minimizes the waist and emphasizes the hips. Whoa, she was a classic. Can't see that fucker coming back, can you? Help! Help! Would you like a power belt, madam? No, I'm all right, thanks. I don't need any because my joggers pull right up just underneath my tits. Yeah, so they just stay up like magic, they do. I like sportswear. Yeah, it's not going to happen, is it? You must have toy. My Little Pony from Mattel. That was your must have toy. And Cabbage Patch dolls. Still don't get it. Births and deaths. Billy Fury died. Dick Emery, I used to love Dick Emery. And Karen Carpenter of The Carpenters. One of the most recognisable voices ever. And like we said, Marvin Gaye. Yeah, so some absolute legends dead. Who's going to replace them? Hey, come on, let's wheel them out. Cheryl fucking Cole. Emily Blunt. And sadly, not long enough, Amy Winehouse. Yeah, clearly she's going to pop off in a later episode. But she was born in 83. Loved Amy. What a legend. Right, let's get on to them TV things. The first one was Knight Rider, which speaks for itself. Hey, you see what I did there? You see what I fucking did there? Yeah, literally. The second one, Police Squad. Just stupidly funny. Still watch it to this day. And your last one, I have revisited last week. And it was, I think it was a 4-part or 5-part series called One Summer. Billy and Ichy. Two kids on the run from Liverpool after robbing some cash off his mum. I binge-watched it, like I say, and it's brilliant, absolutely brilliant. Well-written, although the writer took his name off it after it had been filmed, because I don't think he thought it was acted as well as it could have been. Great storylines. Unusually, at the time, a piece of drama that was for kids, really, but with very adult themes and current things that people were going through in Liverpool, not just Liverpool, but other cities at that time. And it highlighted kids like Icky, who he just lived for the moment and for the crack. He was an absolute fucktard. And we've all had mates like that, and some of us have still got mates like that. And we have mates like that because they're like that. But check it out on YouTube. If you haven't seen One Summer for years and years, it's very, very good. Very good. And I really enjoyed it anyway. So that was 83. Join me in 84 when Torval and Dean will be pissing about on ice. Yeah. The miners are kicking off. Fucking hell, they're off crackers at Orgreave. Yeah. And Tommy Cooper will die. Just like that. See you later, peeps. Thanks for watching. Ta-da!